Hi guys, so I decided to recreate my BeautyCon Dallas look for you all. The outfit details will be below. Let's get into this hair and this makeup because that is what you guys want to see, right? So let's get into it. Hi guys, so this is going to be a talk through. It's been a minute since I've done one of these. Step by step, not the whole entire process, but I am going to go step by step. Excuse if you can hear that blowing in the background. I have my little portable heater going. Dallas don't know if it's going to be cold or hot. And girl, she's not going to turn on the heat. I just have my little bitty one blowing right here. So enough of all of that. I just want to explain that because you might hear that noise. This is going to be my look that I wore to the BeautyCon Dallas, okay? It's the same look I wear all the time. I've done this tutorial only before. Only thing I do is change the lip color or I change the waterline color. The waterline is either white or black and the lip is either whatever color. But I wanted to show you guys this wig, too. That is the star of the show, okay? So I'm going to show you guys that. Okay, guys, this wig came from Ozo Wigs, and it says Beauty and Style. Absolutely love this box. You guys had so many questions about this wig, so I'm super excited to show it. So this is what the box looked like. You have all of your information right here, and I will zoom in a minute to show you that. You just lift it open like this. This box is very doable. So your wig will come in plastic with the company sticker right here. There is tissue paper in here that says Ozo Wigs also. You will get a brush and you will also get a wig cap. So let's just zoom in so I can tell you guys the details right there. Hope you guys can see that. Let's see, the product name is Highlight Bob Full Lace. There we go. BOB 021. Hair color is same as picture, which is that pretty, pretty blonde with streaks. Hair length is 14 inch hair. So this is how this wig falls straight out of the box. It's a little bit weird for me because I'm used to wearing my part over here, but I switched it up. So as you can see, there's not a lot of maintenance you have to do to it. Just bump it with the flat iron, and it's kind of like one of those easy throw on and go type wigs. You see how the texture is just gorgeous. It's silky, but still has a little coarseness to it, and it's not all stringy and shiny looking. Me, you, and a lot of other people absolutely love this wig for me wearing it this weekend, okay? So yeah, there you have it. I will leave the link below. It is an awesome wig. Oh, I just love it. I just love it. I just love it. And of course, you can get it in other colors, okay? Okay, now that you guys know all the details of that bum wig, I mean, everybody at BeautyCon on Instagram, on Snapchat, wanted to know about this wig. And it's like, I feel like it's perfect for my skin tone. I never thought that I would be a blonde girl, but I absolutely love that color, okay? So let's just get straight into the makeup. Okay, you guys know I wear contacts, and that's because they are prescribed. Obviously, I can't see. By the way, these glasses are from glassesshop.com, and everything that I mentioned will be below. This is going to be a voiceover. I mean, this is going to be a talk through because I don't want to have to do a voiceover. I don't know if I already said that, but here are my contacts. My contacts came from MapleLenses.com, but I've sold these suckers out, honey. So I've been linking you guys to Pinky Paradise. So yeah, that link is always below the video. And I think Pinky Paradise is sold out in a lot of prescriptions also. So check them out. So I'm just going to pop these in. So I've been wearing contacts since I was 13, so I don't need a mirror or anything. So I just... for me. So next I'm just gonna take a Huggies and wipe my face down. I just always do that to make sure I don't have any residue on my face. And just wipe your, you guys know how to wipe your face. And I keep this same wipe and use it throughout my entire makeup process because I might need to wipe something off or wipe a swatch off my hand. My next step is I always clean up my eyebrows. This is just a razor you can get at like the beauty supply. I buy them in bulk, like 25 at a time in a box. Wholesale, but they're like 99 cents. So I just go and take all the extra hair off because believe it or not, that makes a big difference when you're drawing your eyebrows on. If you guys follow me on Snapchat, you know that this Belief Aqua Balm is like my favorite. So I'm just going to use this to moisturize and let it sit in for a minute. So we're good and moisturized. Next step is primer. You guys know when I'm going to be gone for a long time taking a lot of pictures, I like to prime with Milk of Magnesia because I am extremely oily and this is what stops my makeup from breaking down throughout the day. Now remember, if you're not oily, do not use this and do not use it on a daily basis. I have a video on it, I will link below. And you guys know I love to use my little toothbrush thing. It's like an Artiste brush dupe and I got the whole set now, but I don't think I'm going to do a video on it. Color Beautiful has a great dupe video on it. I will leave it below. And that's because I don't have the real ones to compare them to. So it's kind of like, yeah. So anyway, I just put this where I get extra oily, which is typically my nose, this area right here, like cheek, kind of like under the eye, and right here in my forehead. Not going to prime the eyes because I'm not wearing eyeshadow. I just put a little bit of the Milk of Magnesia in the eyes too. And that's what you see popping up is the Milk of Magnesia. It's already fighting the oil, okay? And once someone left a video, was like, why don't you guys just use primer? Obviously, primers don't work. Some people's skin, okay? Anyway, lips. So let's prime the lips. This is EOS Lip Balm. I always do this to get your lips prepared for the lipstick, especially now this liquid lipstick phase. So I'm prepped and primed, honey. Let's go to the brows. So I always comb through my eyebrows. Major key alert, okay? I always make sure your eyebrow pencil is sharpened, okay? That plays a big part in it to me. It just makes sure that the line is precise and neater. And this is Jordana Pencil Fabubrow in Midnight Brown. Right here, dark brown actually, and I'm just gonna do my eyebrows. I line them first. Without the camera cut. Then I start from the end because I like my tail darker. And just fill in areas. Then I just take this end and comb it out. Leave this beginning open because I pull the color to the beginning so my beginning is not so dark. And then we're just gonna clean them up. Okay guys, I can't even lie. One day I ran out of concealer, so I said, I have two shades of the Kat Von D Lock It foundation. This one is a little dark, if you can see, and this one is like a shade and a half lighter than my skin tone. So I just use this to conceal with now. So I just put a little drop on the back of my hand. You guys know this stuff does not move. I clean up the top and bottom with it. And when I clean up the bottom, I just take the remaining of the product down and go ahead and conceal out my eyelid. The discoloration in my eyelid. So I just take a fluffy blending brush and, like I said, just mute out my eyelid because I'm not wearing any eyeshadow with that same Kat Von D. Now we can move to the top. Same procedure. I just take the brush. Voila. Okay, so next what I do is take the Makeup Forever Duo Matte Powder because my eyelids get really, really wrinkled. What the fuck am I talking about today? They get really, really, really oily. And I'll take that same fluffy brush and just set my eyelids with it. Nothing major. But I don't even add a brow bone highlight or anything. Now my brows with it. And this kind of like sets them too. Quite flinkish. Just pull my waterline out and apply it, and then let it sit like this for a minute before it and let it dry, I'm sorry, and then do this, or the white will transfer in my tight line and in my eye. So I just do it like that. Okay, so like I said, I just hold it down and let it dry so that it won't transfer, and then I'm done. Okay, so then I take the Bum Schwing liquid eyeliner. I just started using this, so I still have to get used to the applicator. So, and I just wing my eye out. I just draw a line like that for guidance and bring it back down like that and connect the dots, honey. Then I take my Benefit Their Real Mascara and I put that on the top line before I apply my lashes. And the lashes I love to use when I'm doing events is the Coco Lashes and Goddess, okay? And I reuse them over and over and over again, like 20 times. I'm not lying, you guys. So, yeah, that's what I'm doing, is applying my mascara. And I'm going to do my bottom mascara after I do my face. Now, on myself, I don't use any kind of fancy tools or anything. I just pop it on. Okay, my holy grail, the only foundation I will wear, period, if I'm going to event and I'm going to be taking a lot of pictures and etc., is the Estee Lauder Double Wear. I have a pump on it. That's a and I just got a new bottle, so I'm super excited because this color is Amber Honey. I absolutely love this foundation, okay? Kind of oranges, but I don't know. I like my foundations with a little bit of orangey reddish tone because they pick up on camera better. I don't know, when I go with the Real Cool foundations, my sister be looking ashy. Anybody got time for that, especially when them flashes hit. So this is my Sedona Lace 480 brush. I'm just going to put my foundation on, you guys. Yeah, you have to be cool. I mean, I know you feel like you don't want to look orange, and if you're not orange, but I do have orange undertones. But anyway, but sometimes that cool foundation, baby, them flashes and stuff will hit. Hey, you looking like Casper. So, yeah. Anyway, work that into the face. Take the excess to my neck a little. And that's what I'm doing, just applying this awesome foundation. Estee Lauder needs to sponsor me. Tweet them and let them know, guys. Okay, you guys know I always take my sponge. This one is from Makiza Beauty. Love it. It is just so soft, and push that on into my skin. And I don't color correct because, honestly, if you have a good full coverage foundation, you don't even need to do all that, honey. That's the money marketing strategy, okay? So, anyway, let's move on to the concealer to highlight, which will be that Kat Von D foundation. You see how it's a tad bit lighter, so I'm able to use it to highlight. Not a big bright highlight, but just to give definition to my face. And you have to move really fast with this Kat Von D foundation because it dries really fast and it's really thick. But baby, once it's on, it is not budging. So under the eye, let me let the color adjust on the camera. I just put a little bit on the sponge and work it in like that. I've already done this eye, if you guys can tell. I like to push it up. Gives me like a little facelift, honey. Here we are, almost flawless. What you will see me using next is the Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder. And I use it with that same sponge, Sephora. So I'm just going to set my face where I put that Kat Von D foundation, of course the lighter foundation. And while I bake, I go in with MAC Giga Black Zoom Lash and Benefits They're Real and do my bottom lashes. And I like a lot of these guys. So this is what make my look pop to me. So now I take my MAC MSF in dark and I set the remaining on my face. A lot of people say they shine with this, but I don't have any problems. I just push it in, and with the excess, I just blend my neck in. But I just push it in everywhere that Laura Mercier powder is not at. And it kind of like bronzes me a little bit too and pull my color back into my face a lot. Then I just brush that powder off. And I never have a problem with my lash back. Look at my Instagram photos. Nightlife. Then make sure that mascara is extra dry under your eyes and then brush this powder off. So I take the City Color Cosmetics Contour Effects Palette, the original one, and I use the contour shade. And I'm just going to apply that with a fan brush, okay? And I'm just going to use that to contour a little bit. I'm not going to contour my nose at all. My nose is already contoured from highlighting and with the foundation. So my camera keeps cutting off and I'm not catching it. So I thought I was recording, but my all-time favorite blush is this Love Struck powder, Glam Glow powder. Number 112 Pudding Pop from JCAT Cosmetics. I love this color. Just look at it. Look at it. It is freaking gorgeous. So what I do, smile, pop it on that apple, and drag it into my contour. And last, on the face, got the wrong palette. I had this Becca Jaclyn Hill palette, but that's not what I'm going to use. Okay, back to the schedule program. Timeless Beauty Palette from City Color Cosmetics. You guys have to grab this palette. Not only are the blushes in here beautiful, camera is kind of washing it out. Look at that. But the highlighters are. So I'm going to take this first gold color right here in the middle, and this one I'm going to highlight with. You know the highlighted areas. Your chin, your cupid's bow. And this is my favorite brush to highlight, the e.l.f. Small Tapered Blush. You can get it from e.l.f. Small Tapered Brush. You can get it from Target or something for $3. And yeah, I'm just using that gold out of the City Color Cosmetics palette, okay? And of course my battery will be blinking. Just go light that face up. Okay, so let's do the cheeks real quick because my battery is blinking. And I'm just going to pop that right there. So my lips are Ofra Cosmetics Wine Plum. I think I said wine on Instagram. I'm going to line my lips and fill them in with that. Then I take Ofra Cosmetics Atlantic City and fill in the rest. And that's how I got the lip combo you guys were asking about. Gorgeous, right? Freaking gorgeous.